너야.
Welcome to the unbox and review of the IOTA 360 interchangeable laptop stroke tablet. Well, it's just arrived on Amazon Prime, as you can see, and the box, just a standard box. Windows 10, the IOTA 360 with Intel inside. On the back, it's a convertible notebook, 11.6 HDTN touchscreen display, giving you a resolution of 1366 by 768, so full HD. It's got the Intel Atom quad-core processor, which bursts to 1.98. The camera is a 0.3 megapixel. It's got a built-in 32 gigabytes eMMC storage with 2 gigabytes of RAM, an 8000 mAh battery with average battery life of 7 hours with standard use. And it also features Bluetooth 4, Wi-Fi, micro SD slot and mini HDMI and USB times 2. Now, when we open the box, let's see what we've got inside. Quite a nice packaging actually for the price. The price point on this item when I bought it on Amazon Prime was down from £199.99 and it was down to £149.99, but I have heard in the past they have done this product as low as £99.99. So out of the box, it's a nice sleek silver, no branding on it at all. And looking at the side here, you've got one of your USB slots, you've got where your memory card goes into, and you've also got your charging port. On the other side, you've got what looks like, it's a USB 3, so much faster connection with a USB 3. You've also got your headphone jack and your mini HDMI, so you'll be able to obviously put that onto your television or onto a computer screen as well by plugging in. So it welcomes you when you open it up, tells you where your camera is, which is just here in the front underneath the Windows logo, your earphone socket, which is here, your USB, your micro SD, as we've already spoke about, and your power button as well. And on this side, it's got your microphone, which is just on the front of the screen here. Then you've got your power indicator, which I'm sure we'll see shortly, and I'm sure it'll light up nice bright colours. Your DC in sockets and your USB and your mini HDMI. Right, so we'll put the computer aside just now and we'll see what else is in the box. Open up the side pouch here and we have inside the little plastic bag, we have the micro USB to USB cable. We've also got the charging cable, which is standard USB, to the pin, which will fit in the side of the PC. And then inside the little box at the end here, we have your USB charging plug with a UK adapter. But also in the box, quite neat, you've got a European adapter as well. So if you do a lot of travel, then that's going to be handy for you as well. Just a quick change by pressing the button on the back, and that means you can then put it into your European charging mode. On the other side, I presume underneath here, we're going to have an instruction or a quick start guide. Yep, we certainly do. All that space for such a little booklet. So that's your IOTA 360 quick start guide, which comes also in French and German as well. It's quite a small guide, but I'm sure it's got all the information that you will require. So we'll just move this out of the way just now, and we will get from the back of me, we have our little tablet. Now we'll turn that on, and we will see how we get on with it this time. Turn it on there just now, let's see how quick it is to boot up. There we have there, IOTA, which is the branding of it on the screen. We'll see how fast it is to boot up. Obviously, it is just as for £149, you're not going to expect something that's going to boot up as quick as a PC that you're paying £1,000 or £2,000. And essentially, it is a tablet, a glorified tablet, which is made to look like a small netbook stroke laptop. So we just try and get in there. There we go. And it's going to ask for my password, which I will put in. And there we go. A little timer's spinning round and round while it finds itself. But this has only been turned on previously to set up and put a Microsoft account in it, just to let you see the speeds that you can actually get out of it. So as you can see, it's not the fastest, it's not the slowest one out there. Your standard Windows setup and your trackpad here on the keyboard, it works like your normal trackpad, except it's not got separate buttons, it's just pressing on either the left or the right hand side for your left and right hand side button. Pretty bog standards, not a lot of bloatware on here at all. It just looks as if it's got your standard Microsoft stuff, where you can get Office, your games, etc. from the App Store. So we'll do that and we'll see how we get on the nets. This is Internet Explorer. Personally, I use Firefox, which hasn't been put on it yet, but I will get around there to putting that on. So this is actually the first time it's went onto the net. So if you bear that in mind, it's not got nothing in its memory. Microsoft Edge, the faster, safer browser designed for your life. Okie dokie. There we go. Not a problem. So what we'll do is, so we'll do a wee standard speed test. Bear in mind, I'm using Virgin Media, where I have what's meant to be 50 meg broadband. So we'll see what this little tablet can perform with when we do that. A wee bit jittery on the net for the first time there, as you can see when you're trying to get onto some of the sites, it's a wee bit jittery, but I'm sure we'll get there. And there we go, we'll do this. It's Cortana just saying hi, I'm here to help if you want me to. I have turned Cortana off because I will be totally honest with you, I don't particularly like her voice, but that's just a personal preference. Here we go. That one's not really doing what I want it to do, so we'll try an old famous Ookla. I do like Ookla. Here we go, and we'll just hit start. So at the moment it's showing us download speeds of 15.8, 22.8 meg, and it's ping on it just now is under one millisecond, so it was showing me an average of 19.75 megabytes per second and an upload of 3.75 megabytes per second. So what we'll do now is we'll jump on to YouTube and we will have a little listen to a video and let you hear what the sound quality is. Just waiting on YouTube opening, as you can see. We'll go for an old firm favourite of mine. We'll go for a bit of No Mercy and Where Do You Go? And we'll see what the sound quality is for that. Now, so far, I would say this is rather ideal for kids or for maybe a second computer for travel, if you're going on holiday, if you're going out the country, so you don't need to lug a big computer. Quite a clear picture as well. And we'll go into the function button here, which then gives us the volume control. That's 100% just now. Well, as you can see, I would say that's semi-decent for the price point, giving you quite clear sounds. It's not going to run a nightclub for you, and it's definitely going to be alright if you're wanting to maybe watch a movie on the go, etc. So we'll just turn that down just now. There we go. Now, the good thing about this little product here is it's versatile. You can turn it and you can have it so that it's working like so. So if you're watching a movie or you want to use it in tablet mode, because it is obviously full touchscreen, and you can shove it even further back and then that gives you it in tablet mode there, guys, where you can use the product in like a tablet And you can also, on the side here, there's an on-off button, which you can switch off, which means that the keypad will now be off, so you're not going to risk when you're touching any of the keys or you're doing anything on it. So basically, for 149 quid, it's costing roughly what a tablet would cost you to buy, but it's giving you the versatility of your USB ports, and also it's giving you the versatility of having your keyboard. I personally like some of these smaller items for gimmicky things for when I'm travelling, so I've got it in the car as well, so that I'm not without a PC. And as I said, it's small, it's durable, quite a nice colour, the two speakers there, which are giving that sound out. Obviously they're bouncing off the hard surface underneath, which does help to project it ever so slightly as well. So for £149, I would definitely say it was worth having a look at, especially if you have kids and it's maybe going to be their first laptop or their first tablet. Definitely worth it at £149. Thanks for joining us here at In The Know. Hopefully we will see you soon. Remember, subscribe at the bottom here and give us a like as well. When I am gone.